This morning, Time's list of the 100 most influential people is out, and making the cut is Republican National Committee Chairman Reince Priebus. He already has one of the tougher jobs in politics, and now he's embroiled in an increasingly contentious campaign season, with Donald Trump accusing him of rigging the delegate system and the Republican establishment blaming him for letting Trump get this far. We have CNN special correspondent Jamie Gingell, who spent an exclusive day with the RNC chairman, and she shows us a different side of the man in the middle.
This poor man, he has a life.
This poor man.
Before Donald Trump, I don't think it's the toughest, I think it's the worst job in Washington. His life before Donald Trump, he was this middle of this firestorm, getting attacked from both sides. So we asked him whether there are any shenanigans going on. But we started by asking him a question.
So he says he's not putting Baileys in his cereal, which is hilarious for
not
him to
yet.
Say that.
Not yet.
But who knows? Maybe he will. It's not as if he just has an issue with Donald Trump. He may be here on Time's 100 most influential list, but he has kind of issues with a lot of folks in his party.
Right. In fact, it is in order to energize his base. He's been bending over backwards. He's been too fair to Trump. So I just want to tell you, if he does start drinking, I took a peek in the fridge in his, that's all I will say.
All right. Jamie Gingell, thank you so much. Michaela.
All right, to a story that
leading in the polls in Pennsylvania, it's the richest delegate prize in next Tuesday's primaries in the Northeast. Despite losing big in New York, Bernie Sanders says he's not going anywhere and he plans to challenge Clinton all the way to the Democratic convention in Philadelphia this summer. And joining us now, we have Karen Finney for being with us. And I want to ask you about something that I'm hearing from a lot of people in the Clinton camp, people who back the Secretary Clinton. They basically are saying that Bernie Sanders needs to dial down some of his rhetoric. But if we go back 8 years ago, Hillary Clinton was in the race. She was obviously trying to win it. It was very divisive. Some of her criticisms of then-Senator Obama were obviously sharp. Why should Bernie Sanders do something different than what she did?
Well, actually, Clinton aide, and this is a quote I'm going to read you.
Well, I'm going to agree. That's not exactly something that's making you feel conciliatory.
Well, but
campaign, even though it says senior Clinton aide.
I don't believe that, but has also said that if Hillary Clinton ends up...
Listen, I want you to hear what Jeff Weaver, the campaign manager, and as you know, he's been pretty bullish on this idea of flipping some of these superdelegates, but listen to what he just said a short time ago on New Day. One of the chief priorities that he noted there, Karen, was advancing the senator's agenda, which it sort of sounds like something the Clinton campaign is okay with, stick to the issues. When you hear him say that, are you reading into that?
Well, I would hope.
Karen Finney, senior spokesperson with the Clinton campaign. Chris?
All right, Brianna.